Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. In one place, in our Upanishad, it is said, Yato Vacho Nivartante Aprapya Manasasaha. The truth is that which is beyond the scope of the speech and mind. If this we understand in letter and spirit, problem is this only. If we understand in letter and spirit, what will happen? For example, on the cigarette packet it is written, cigarette smoking is injurious to health. So we read it. And after that, we say, okay, give 2 packets. So what we read has no meaning for us. And we continue smoking. See? And suppose we read it and it happens correctly to us, the net result will be, we'll stop smoking. Many, many years before, there was one boy who met me. He said, Swami, I have understood what you said. I said, what did I say and what you understood? He said, you told words can change our life. I said, how? Then he told his story. He said, once I was going by train and went to some station and wanted to board the train, waiting for the train. Those days, AC and all that was not there. Simple trains, 3 tires maximum. So, on the station, there were some hoardings. Travelling without ticket is a crime. He said, I had decided that I am going to go without ticket. And when I read that, it started ringing in my mind. When I was struggling, I should buy or I should not buy, I should buy, I should not buy. Then I decided I should buy. But his friend told, no, no, I am not going to buy, I don't care. And therefore, he did not buy. And as it were, exactly he was caught. So those words he has read and it had made an impact on him, is it not? The other person had no impact. If these examples are clear, then come to the scriptures. Yato vacho nivartante aprapya manasasaha. The truth is that it is beyond the scope of the speech and the mind. What should happen? See, hear, but don't talk. Dekho, suno, bolo mat. Because we already heard it. The truth is beyond the scope of the speech and the mind. What is there to talk? So the real satsang is, keep your mouth shut. He phrase. Therefore in Dakshinamurti, Dhyana Shlokas, it is said, Mauna Vyakhya, Prakatita para Brahma Tattvam Yuvanam Chitram Vatataror Mule Vruddha Shishya Guru Yuva Gurostu Maunam Vyakhyanam Shishyastu Chinna Samchaya. And yet we see scriptures are filled with hundreds and thousands of mantras. And what are those mantras? See, friends, the mantra is the reality, the Brahman, Paramatma, Bhagavan is Satyam, Jnanam, Anantam, Brahma. These are words. See? Then why these words are said? Is it that the Satyam, Jnanam, Anantam, Brahma is describing the truth? No, it is not disturbing. Then, to negate the possibility of absence, asat, therefore sat is said. To deny the possibility of the achit, jada, inert, the chit is said. To deny the possibility of misery is ananda is said. But that doesn't mean the truth is Satchidananda, no. See how subtle it is. Similarly, when it is said, God is all-pervading. All-pervading means what? He is everywhere. Be attentive. He is everywhere means what? Everywhere is space. God is everywhere in the space. Therefore, space is the reality in which God is the content or what? Then why this is said? It's only because we are conditioned by time, space and object. So we will understand only that language which is known to us. See friends, therefore we start talking about the God. He is omnipresent, He is present everywhere. That means the space is the reality, everywhere Bhagavan is there. Then He knows everything, omniscient. See friends, therefore when we contemplate systematically and deeper and deeper, then we come to know that all these things begin only because of an illusion which we take to be real. And that illusion is an imagination of inside and outside. Now what is our experience? I am inside the body and you are all outside the body. Samsara begins. That experience where inside and outside is taken as the real and valid, that moment onward samsara begins. In the deep sleep, there is no concept of inside and outside, and therefore there is no samsara. And inside and outside can happen always with reference to some point. So, the object is in my pocket, but you are outside the pocket. Then we are inside the hall, the shoes are outside the hall, the shoes are inside the premises, the car is outside the premises. So, to make in and out, you have to have some reference point. And what is the reference point for us? Body identification. Yesterday I told you, again contemplate on this, it's a very important thing. Our present notion is, I am inside the body, the mind is inside and the world is outside. But nothing can ever exist for us which is not included in our mind. It is not included in our mind, it doesn't exist for us. See, that day probably I told you the example. There was something wrong with my toe, so my friend, he said, I'll do the operation and remove it. I said, all right. So I sat on the chair, put my leg on the stool. He gave local anesthesia. After 15 minutes, he checked whether there is still sensation. When there was no sensation, he said, now you can watch the operation. And he nicely cut my toe. I saw that he's cutting my toe, and then also the blood is oozing out. He took out whatever he has to take out from that, and then he started stitching, and I had no pain, no nothing. I thought, I have become a great yogi. But that great yogi lasted only for 15-20 minutes. When the toe came out of the meditation, the toe was in chemical meditation. The moment the mind is allowed to permeate the toe, immediately all the pain started happening. Therefore, all experiences are possible if something is included in the mind. And experience doesn't happen outside. See, like I am seeing this mic. So the mic doesn't have experience that somebody is seeing me. I have the experience of seeing the mic. Therefore, every experience requires two things. One is the object of my the experience must be included in the mind, and where the knowledge takes place, there also the mind must be there. Therefore, our mind is not inside the body or outside the body, but the body is in the mind. Work on this. How to work on this? Okay, let us start again contemplative thinking. Our mind has two aspects. Like space has two aspects. One is a common space. Second is our home space. In the same manner, there is a common mind because of which the life is sustained. And then there is a specific mind. Now, how the total mind or the one mind, how it becomes the special mind? Because the mind has taken the shape of the body. And after the mind has taken the shape of the body, thereafter the mind has to think in relation to that body. This is to be observed in day-to-day life. You take any parent and see the child, parent or grandparent. When they start talking about their children or grandchildren, you see the enthusiasm, the love, the appreciation. See, my son, you know, my grandson is so intelligent. He is a dumb actually. But for them, he is so intelligent because that child is included in my mind as a special child. Other children, they are not disciplined. Understand this principle. So mind has got two aspects. One is a common aspect, which is one for all of us. And second is a specific aspect. A specific aspect is nothing but mind has taken the shape of the body. See, friends. And therefore, our mind cannot think without reference to our body. So anything with reference to, in relation to body, that alone is the thought formation process in our mind. And then we get tired. Tired of what? In fact, body doesn't get tired. It is a mind gets tired. See, the mind gets tired of holding on to the shape of the particular body. It is something like this. In a carry bag, there is a pumpkin. You lift the pumpkin. Who is having tension? The pumpkin or the bag? The bag has the tension. Not a pumpkin. In the same manner, in the carry bag of the mind is the pumpkin of the body. Then we take that carry bag with the pumpkin, lift it, tension. Then put it on the floor, tension gone. Tension from where? From the bag, not from the pumpkin. Exactly the same way. In the bag of the mind, he is carried the pumpkin of the body, and his mind gets tired of holding on to the same body for a long period of time, and therefore slowly it gives away. And in deep sleep, because there is no shape taken by the mind of that particular body, there is nobody. And when there is nobody, there is no sense of otherness, there is no sense of limitation. We have to learn and understand this secret of the mind. And see now, Once I conducted his experiment in one management. Management is a myth. Mismanagement is the truth. So in one of such a management conference, I was conducting this. And I wanted to emphasize or prove one point. So I said, now today we'll have some game. We have to learn some principle, we'll have some game. Like the children we teach through games, management also is same thing, no difference. You go and attend all management conferences. Same rubbish. So, matching to their way, I conducted our experiment. All the necktie brand were there sitting and all that. I said, may I know, is there somebody Sindhi among you? So one Sindhi, yes, I am. Please come. He came. And I had already organized earlier. There was one papad. See? Like, you know, Ganapati, Modakam Samarpayami, Sindhi, Papadam Samarpayami. Every god has got a different offering. So he came, then I told him, please lift the papad, don't eat, and hold it at the shoulder level. He held like this. And then I changed the topic and talked some about something. My attention was there. After a few moments, his hand started going down. I said, come on, lift it. No down, going down. Again, he lifted. Again, after some time, going down. 2-3 times he did. Ultimately, he said, I can't hold it anymore. I said, our experiment over. Eat the papad and go back. I said, now let us analyze this experiment. When you held the papadam for the first time, suppose the weight of that papadam is 5 grams. After 3-4 minutes, has the weight of the papad increased? Why are you tired? See, friends, whatever insignificant anything there may be, if we hold on to that for too long, we get tired in life. And therefore, we go to sleep. So what is the sleep? Sleeping, whatever we were holding on to, that we drop. See, friends. And that time, what happens to the mind? The mind merges back in the total mind. Like when the hall walls are pulled away, what will happen to the hall space? It will merge with the total space. Even when the walls are not destroyed, yet is the total space and the hall space separate from each other? See, friends. Therefore, the conclusion is the in and out, this illusion is the samsara. We have to drop it. So how to drop it? With this understanding. Don't hold on to anything too fast. Learn to forget and drop. It is for this principle we emphasize again and again. Do not talk about your past memories. But old people, all the time the same. When we were children, see, we never used to have shoes to go to the school. We used to go without any shoes. But these days, the children, who asked you? And what do you want to prove? See? During our childhood, we never had our own pant. We used to get inherited pant from the first brother. Who asked you? The reason is, we are holding on to the body identification. See, friends. Therefore, na bahyo antara sakshi buddhar desho tau ubhau. Therefore, in and out is a concept of the mind. Drop this concept. And how the concept is formed? Because the mind has taken the shape of the body. Drop it. Today we were sitting, we were seeing something, a classical dance. Myself, my friend, Vivek and Archana. So she was showing me something. I said, Yasin, now again, do what I'm telling you. Again, we went backside. I said, now again, I'll start. Don't look at the dancing girl, but look at the screen of the laptop. And again, we started. Then I told this experience, wherein although everything was happening on the screen, but your attention was not what is happening on the screen. Your attention was on the screen. Therefore, nothing can disturb you. Exactly the same way. All experiences are happening on the or in the mind in the form of reflections, pratibimba. But attention is on the mind. Then we'll very clearly experience joy and sorrows. These are reflections on the mind. Mind is neither joyful nor sorrowful. We experience both joy as well as sorrows. So where are we influenced? We are not influenced. So all these things are happening only in the mind, and unfortunately, never we are taught right from childhood till date how to work on the mind. That we have to mind our mind. We take care of everything in life except our mind. And whole life is lived only by the mind. See, friends. And therefore, these are the principles. So, na bayo nantaram sakshi buddher deshau hi tau uhau buddhya adi asesa samshantam. And when this concept of in and out is dissolved in two ways, one way is go to sleep, second way is through wisdom. What will be the wisdom way? Wisdom way will be, we move in this world, we see everything, and yet not a single desire erupts in our mind. What is a desire? Desire is reaction of the mind to the perception is a desire. Mirror doesn't have desire because mirror reflects, rejects nothing, at the same time retains nothing. Why it doesn't retain? Because it doesn't react. And reaction is always in the form of words, speech. Oh, how beautiful. Oh, so dirty. Constantly, mind is reacting in life. So how to live? As you are listening to Vedanta, same way listen to the worldly thing. Listening for so many years, did not touch us, no reaction. But if somebody tells that you are dumb, immediately reaction comes. See, friend. Therefore, this technique we have, and we can experience, but we need not react. Now, continuing further, desha kopi na bhaseta yadi tarhi astu adesha bha sarva desha prakrutteiva cha sarva gatvam natu svataha. Because our attention is on the space, so we will talk only with reference to space. So what we will say? God is everywhere. It is something like, we talk about the ocean. Ocean is in every wave. No, ocean is in every wave, or all the waves are in the ocean? Be attentive. One same example. All colors and forms, they are in the vision. if this is true or it is vision alone which is creating all colors and forms. If there are no colors and forms, there is no loss to the vision. But if there is no vision, no colors and forms. Therefore, vision is cause unmanifest without any specific qualities. And when the same thing becomes grossified, specialities, qualities come. Like Shabda, one of the tanmatra of the space. Shabda. Shabda means sound, any sound. But that any sound is made special. Sa, re, ga. Three frames. Therefore, whenever we add any special status, any speciality, samsara is created. And behind that samsara, Paramatma is hidden. See, out of one woman, a daughter is created, a wife is created, and a mother is created. Therefore, the woman or the stri is hidden behind the daughter, behind the wife, and behind the mother. And who is miserable or happy? These three fellows who exist nowhere. Therefore, desha kopi na bhaseta yadi tari. If you say, but in this absolute reality, there is no space. Because it is because of this that a space has existence. In one Upanishad, this thought comes. That student asked the teacher, sir, where is God? So the teacher says, forget about God. Tell me, where are you? Sir, I am in front of you in your kutia. Very good. Where is the kutia? Kutia is in the ashram. Ashram in Chennai. Chennai in Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu in India. India on globe. Globe in waters. Waters in the fire. Fire in the air. Air in the space. Where is the space? Space is in our mind. When the mind is enfolded as in deep sleep, where are we? Question ends. So where is the space? Space is only an imagination of expanse. Now, where is the mind? Mind is in the life. See, in the inert, there is no mind, life. And what is life? Life is the expression of the divine energy. And the divine energy belongs to whom? To the God, to Paramatma, to Brahman, to Shiva. So where is everything? Everything is in Paramatma. But we say Paramatma is everywhere. This is called as upside down understanding. Like we ask that, is there gold in the ornament? Wrong question. The ornament is superimposed on the gold. It is not that the ornament is created and then the gold is injected into that. No. See, friends. Therefore, deshaha kopina bhaseta yadip. If you say in this absolute, there cannot be any space, so what? It is not necessary. Therefore, sarva desha prakruteiva sarva gatam tu na svataha. Because our attention is on the space, then we say, oh, Paramatma is everywhere. Because our attention is on present and absent, therefore we say, Paramatma is sat. Our experience is jada chetan, inert and sentient. Therefore we say, Paramatma is sentient. Chit. This is how translating our experiences in a language by which we go beyond the limitations of the language is the technique of the scriptures to communicate the truth. We have to ourselves understand And only words are not enough. We have to drop the words and go beyond. Therefore, antar bahirva sarvam va yam desham parikalpayil buddhista deshagaha sakchi tatha vastushu yoje. So antar bahirva yam desham parikalpayil. So our mind keeps on imagining outside and inside. And therefore, the problems begin. See? Today also, when we are sitting, we are discussing this. A very simple example. In Upanishad, this mantra comes, then I will tell you our day-to-day examples. It is said, Yasmin sarvani bhutani atmani eva anupashyati sarva bhutastam atmanam na tato vijugupsate. When a seeker comes to discover everything is in me and I am in everyone, then na tato vijugupsate, thereafter there cannot be vijugupsa. Vijugupsa means hatred. We don't have to have love. Absence of hatred is love. See? Now to understand this, take a simple example. I was telling them, in Delhi it happened, there was one girl, must be in her mid-20s or so. She used to come regularly for the talks. And when she came, then I again met her in her place for breakfast. I saw her fingers. I said, hey, show me. They were so beautiful, long nails, colored red. That was the first time in my life I have seen such long nails of a girl from near. Then I asked her, I said, hey, what do you eat? So nice red nails. My nails are not red, why? Swamiji, this is not, actually we are given a painting. I said, very nice. But so perfect shape. No, Swamiji, no, nothing. She became very uncomfortable. Next day when she came for the lecture, she was holding her fingers like this and sitting. Now my attention was only at her hands. Why she is sitting like this? And after the lecture was over, I said, hey, come here, come here. She came. Swami, I said, show me your hand. No, no, I said, show, I want to see. I saw that she had cut them all. I asked her, I said, hey, why did you cut them? I like them so much. Where are they? Please give me them. Then Swamiji, I have thrown them. Now attentive. When the nails are included in the definition of I, we don't hate them. When the nails are separated from the definition of I, we hate them. Mahatmas don't love anybody. Then they don't hate anybody. Absence of hatred is the expression of love. See? And how the love happens? Your day-to-day experiences. In Mumbai, after my talk, one young mother came with her baby. That boy must be about 7 months, 8 months. He says, Swamiji, I wanted to come for so many days, but I could not manage today. I decided to come. She came. Everybody took prasad on the last day. And last she came. So when people come and take prasad, they give something. So she came and she put her son in my lap. I said, Mama, you are the best. No, no, Swamiji. I said, no, I'll tell you how you are the best. Other people have come and given this money which I am not interested. You have given me your son as Guru Dakshina. Thank you so much. Now I am going to make him a Babaji. I am not going to. And she started crying. No. I said, look here. I am sitting on the Vyasapeet. You have given me Dakshina in front of everything, everybody. Now you cannot take it back. She started crying. And I was enjoying. is a great fun in having fun in life. You don't have to be all sort of serious. And when I was just talking, that useless child, he did in my lap what he should not have done. I got so disgusted. Oh God, take this dirty fellow. He thinks I am a toilet or what? Take him away. The moment I said like this, she was so happy. Swamiji, you are really divine. I said, what happened, divine? Last 3 days, he has not gone. Now tell me, if somebody else's child had done in my lap, what would have been her response? They don't have any manners how to give. So to Swamiji, the child, this is not the way. But when it is the own child, even that shit was sweet. See, friend, because there is no hatred. Saints and sages, they don't hate anybody. Therefore, they don't have to love anybody. See, friends, this is practice of knowledge in life. See, it is very simple. And the root cause is body identification. After body identification only, the whole samsara begins. First step on the spiritual path, this is the only thing. We have to attain freedom from body identification. Next time you go and stand in front of the mirror, after having seen your beautiful face, then drop that face and simply look at the surface of the mirror. Your focal length will completely change. So seeing is happening, but nothing is seen. That seeing where seer is not born is Paramatma. That knowledge where knower is not born is the truth. That joy where enjoyer is not created, that is the reality. Therefore, antarva bahirva desha parikalpaye, this is only imagination by the intellect or a buddhi. Buddhi tad deshaka sakshim tatha vastushi yoje. Therefore, who knows where I am? Everything can become our contemplative moment in life. One day, one person called me. Swamiji, I want to come there. Can you give me the directions? I said, yes. Where are you? Why you should worry where I am? You simply tell me how to come there. I said, okay. Take a flight from Buenos Aires and go to Washington, D.C., Dulles. From there, go to Moscow and then via Beijing, come to Singapore. Swamiji, why are you telling like that? I said, I don't know where you are. Our meditation is like that. For a GPS operation, you require 2 points. Point of origin and the destination. So what is the point of origin of ours? Who is sitting for meditation? A husband. Point of origin. Now who will be his Ishta Devata? Belan Devi. See, friends, we have to find out, where are we? Then we come to know we are lost in the worldly possessions and worldly relations. From there we have to start. Then next step, how these possessions and relations have become so important for me? From the body identification. And therefore, what is the destination? Limitations of the body should not trouble me. Meaning, I should be happy in spite of the body and the limitations of the body. That is the GPS destination. See, If you observe next time your GPS map, the destination is shown by a particular sign, top, and it's known in the, that is exactly Chandanam of Vitthal Bhagwan in Panduranga. So that is the destination of our life. Come back to your divine nature. And how? These are the steps. Give up too much value, importance to the possession, too much getting lost in the relations, and remain effortlessly with yourself. And slowly, slowly, this body, body, body theme will become weak in our mind. And then the contemplation begins. What is the meaning of freedom from body identification? How to get rid of it? But be attentive. You cannot stop your face getting reflected in the mirror. You cannot stop. It will happen. So what is to be done? Break the mirror? No. Break your face? No. Then, no, it is just an appearance, not real. Exactly the same way Paramatma is expressing in the body in the form of I am the body notion. So look at yourself as God is looking at us. Like the mother looks at her child in the same manner. When we start changing our perspective of looking at our experiences, then we will come to know everything is in me, but I am not in anything. If I am not there, there cannot be my father. If I is not there, there cannot be my wife. If I is not there, there cannot be the son. Everything is existing in me, but I am not in them. When my father dies, nothing happens to me. When wife dies, nothing happens to me. When the son dies, nothing happens to me. This substratum, which is supporting everything, but not getting influenced by anything, that is our essential nature. So when we are thus convinced, this conviction must happen. And for that conviction purpose, we have to reflect on this and don't get involved too much in these worldly things. See, I'll tell you an example. This happened about maybe 15 years before. I went to somebody's house, and that was the first grandchild born in that family. So the grandfather, he was holding on to the grandchild continuously, not leaving, and he was telling, see, his mother knows nothing. I have to give him bath, I have to feed him milk, everything, everything. I said, hey, don't get too much involved. Everything is okay in limit. Don't go beyond it. No, Swamiji, she is useless girl. She knows nothing. I said, God bless you before you get kicked out of the house. And as if I said it, after about 6-7 years, I again happened to go to that town and I asked, hey, grandfather, how are you? Your curse has come true. I said, what was the curse? I forgot about it. He said, my daughter-in-law told, in clear terms, either he remains in the house or I remain. He doesn't allow me to love my own child. That time I told him, I said, look here, you have destroyed your life. No, let her destroy her life. Why you help her? See, friends, in this world, we should have this wisdom. Before somebody has to tell, how much you charge to leave the place? Now I am in Archana's house. Why she is so happy? Because she knows tomorrow I am going. Thank God. See, friends, before somebody has to tell us, go, have the wisdom to quit. When we thus live our life with this wisdom, our whole life changes. Then, same with every object. Therefore, yadrupapi kalpeta buddhyatattva prakashayan tasya tasya bhavet sakshi svato vak buddhi agocharah. So, whatever is imagined by the intellect, that imagination is illumined by these consciousness, the sakshi, the witnessing self. See? Be attentive. How do we see an object by the eyes? Object is never seen. It is the image of the object through the lens falls on our retina where the mind is, and then in that mind that image is caught. Now that mind with the image is caught as a thought, and then it is bathing in the light of consciousness, and then the knowledge of that object takes place. So in fact, we don't see the object. What we are seeing is only the image of the object. But what is our understanding? I am seeing the object. Exactly the same way. Whatever is imagined by the mind, that imaginary image is illumined in the light of consciousness, and the rule is, the one which is illuminating is never influenced by what is illumined. Like this light is illuminating, the discourse doesn't become wise, or a disco doesn't become bad. A simple rule. Eyes illuminate the yellow color, they don't become yellow. Illuminate the red color, they don't become red. The rule is, illuminator is not influenced by what is illumined. The knower is not influenced by what is known. If influence happens, somebody is born. Somebody is born only after body identification. Therefore, yajyat rupadi kalpeta buddhya, whatever we are imagining. See? Tat tat prakashayat, all that is imagined, experienced, is illuminated by the witnessing consciousness. So, tasya tasya bhavet sakshi. So, he simply becomes the illuminator of everything. And svataha va buddhi agocharaha. But this conscious reality can never be comprehended by any means of knowledge. I can see this mic. Mind cannot see my eyes. Mind can see the eyes. Eyes cannot see the mind. Intellect can observe the likes and dislikes in the mind. Mind can never observe the wisdom. The life is supporting the intellect. Intellect cannot understand what is life. Ultimately, life is an expression of the divine energy. This life can never know what is divine energy. And the divine energy belongs to the Shiva. So energy can only surrender to Lord Shiva. This is the process. In Kathopanishad, the mantras come. Indriyebhya para yartha arthebhyascha param manaha manasastu para buddhi buddheratma mahan paraha mahataha param avyaktam avyaktat purusha paraha purushanna param kinchit sa kashta sa paragati. See, objects are gross, senses are subtle. Senses are gross, mind is subtle. Mind is gross, intellect is subtle. Individual intellect is gross, total intellect is subtle. then total intellect is grasped, the prakriti, the shakti, that is subtle. The shakti is grasped, Paramatma is subtle. And purushanna param kinchit, beyond his absolute self, there is nothing. It is the ultimate truth. It is not a gain. It is not an achievement. It is rediscovery of our own being. Praptasya prapti Vedanta desa. Therefore, in this world, there is no body realized. In realization, body doesn't remain. A wave, when merges in the ocean, is the wave realized? The wave disappears. These are very subtle points everywhere in our scriptures. Like when we say, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, Om Namo Narayanaya. In this, I is nowhere. Om Namaha Shivaya, salutation to Shiva, salutation to Vasudeva Bhagavan, salutation to Narayana, because the one who salutes, he disappears. If the ornaments have to salute the gold, can the ornament remain separate from the gold? And because what is ornament? Name, form plus gold. So name and form you drop, gold is already there. Exactly the same way, when body identification and associated problems and a notion that we are a soul, one per body, these two notions are to be dropped. But right from childhood, it is so much imposed on our head that I am a soul in the body. And when a yogi dies, the soul goes from above in search of another body. Then, Shuchi Nam Sri Matam Gehe Yoga Vrashto Vijayate or Athava Yogi Nameva Kule Bhoti Dhimatam. This story appears so perfect, but it is not the truth. Only these two things, freedom from body identification and getting rid of the notion that we are a soul in this body. Then what to do with the soul? Make a soul curry. Go to our Goa. In Goa, there is a dish, soul curry. So tasty. Like the Tamilian rasam. As much experience I got about eating food, none of you can have. So make a soul curry. See, friends. Therefore, these are the two obstacles. The first obstacle will be this body disidentification. Get rid of it. Second is the notion that I am a soul in the body. And see the beauty part. Whatever you think that you are, yo ye shraddha sa eva saha. When Bhagwan Ram was moving in the place of Janak Raja, he and Lakshmanji, all the girls were looking at them and they started seeing a beautiful, prosperous groom in them. And saints and sages, they started seeing God in them. Now take in your own houses. When the father looks at the girl or the woman, she is my daughter, he has got a different perception. When the husband looks at the same lady, he is afraid. He doesn't look. When the son is looking after his mother, the same lady, different experience. Exactly the same way. We consider ourselves to be the body, you are bound to be dying. No doubt about it. Asti bhati priya, asti bhati, asti jayate, vardate, viparanamate, apakshiyate, namashta, vinashyati, iti shad vikaravat, etas thulam chariram. It is in the body, then it is born, then it grows vertically, then horizontally, then it becomes old, then it has got diseases, and one day it dies. It will happen. And then you suffer. Why? It is your mistake. Why you have taken yourself to be the body? See, friend, you take yourself to be husband and want to be happy. Nobody can help you. Then you play the role of the husband and be a man. Okay, very simple. And when we play the role, we must play the role so perfect that wife should think that you are the best husband in the world. You may not be. See, all the problems are dissolved by this one simple rule. Play the game of life. Rama Leela, Krishna Leela. Then you take yourself to be a soul. Then you will be born again and again. You will die again. Now all these things only we are accepting without any reason, without any understanding. Somebody told and we accepted. Evaluate, find out. How can I be this body? Then why these things are told in our scriptures? Be very attentive. We are all expert in blaming others for all the problems of our life. If I am a husband, the cause of my misery is my wife. Then what will be the spiritual practice of a husband? Try to improve wife. This is called as ashakyanushthan. You cannot. Net result, frustration. So what the scriptures want? Be responsible for your life. And then all the miseries that come in our life because we have done bad karma in the last life. Oh, immediately we agree. And if you again do bad karma, next life she will be again your wife. No, don't cut a joke. See, friends. But what is the purpose of telling this thing? Purpose is not that you were earlier and not born and did. No. Purpose is you are responsible for your life. Don't blame anybody in this world. Now once we accept last life bad karma, this life next life, what does it mean? It means we are a continuous unbroken conscious existence. That is the meaning. Like probably the other day I told you, before coming to Chennai, I was in Mumbai. Before that, I was in Rishikesh. Before that, I was in Varanasi. Before that, I was in Jaipur. Where did I die? Is it not? I was in the child body disappeared. I am still there. Then young, teenage body came. I was there also. That also disappeared. Should I say, I was born as a child and I died as a child? Then I was born as a teenager. Then I... No. Instead of understanding this way, we are all the time. Last life, this life, next life. You will see all the stories from Puranas, they have got this foundation. In the last life, he has done Mahapap. And we get carried away. See, these stories from the scriptures must be understood what is technically called as Tatparya Nirnay. Tatparya Nirnay in English will mean moral of the story. When something is told, what is the purpose of telling that? See, when we are told, if you do something bad, you will go to hell. The purpose is not sending you to hell. Purpose is that your life should be self-disciplined. That is the purpose. See, friends, we cannot be controlled with love. We can be controlled only by fear. Vishasmad vatapavade, vishodeti suryaha, vishasmad agnischendrascha, mrutyurdhavati panchamayeti. It is under the rod of fear that all the elements are functioning properly. See? Indians, when they are Indian, they are horrible. The same Indians, when they go to Singapore, they behave properly. Why? Not love for Singapore, but the punishment. And their punishment, you break the traffic light. $200 plus 10 whips. And then you have to go and take the whips. And they are so considerate, they don't want to spoil your clothes. So they say, take out your clothes and give right. Three, one, two, three, and you fall unconscious. Then they take you to the hospital and do everything for you. And then on your punishment return, 7 balance. In your whole life, you will never jump there. Friends, it is for this purpose that hell and heaven is told. See, when we want to get something done from the children, we tell, if you do this thing, I'll give you that. Exactly the same way, to have control on our life from within, this element of fear is introduced. Therefore, कथम ताम गुरु मया ग्राह्य इति चेत् मैव गृह्यताम सर्व ग्रहो असम शांतो स्वयमेव अवशिष्यते. In this manner, when it is said, the truth cannot be comprehended through speech, mind, etc., then the student asks the question, then how do I know the truth? If all the 5 koshas are dropped, nothing remains, then there is nothing for me to hold on to, because I know everything only through the sense organs, through the mind and the intellect. Through sense organs, I know the objects. Through the mind, I know the experiences of joy and sorrows. And through the intellect, I know the concepts. If Paramatma is not the object, he is not an experience of joy or sorrows, if not a concept, then how do I know the truth? Then the teacher says, Sarva Grahova Sam Shantau. Don't try to hold on to Paramatma. Give up the wrong notions. In the dream, we dream something very bad. And then frightened, heartbeat has increased and some terrible accident happens and we get out of the dream. So after we get out of the dream, do we have to do anything? Exactly the same thing. From this waking dream, when we awake, the quality of our life will be totally different. We live in the same world, nothing will change. We will change. And what will be the change? You will be happy. Not because of something, but in spite of everything. Because the happiness alone is expressing to us. And what is the expression of happiness? Living at a zero complaint level. No complaint about anything, no complaint about anybody. That is happiness. In the language of Bhagavan Sri Krishna in Gita, Brahma Bhuta Prasanna Atma, who is the one who is ever happy? Not like a man on unnecessarily laughing, no. Then, 2-3 things are told. Number one, na shochati. He doesn't grieve over whatever good or bad has happened in the past. Come on, drop the past. And na kangshati. Doesn't try to solve the non-existing problem. Worry is an attempt to solve the non-existing problem. When you all know 9/11 happened in US, after that, I came to India. And then, within 2-3 days, I was going to Australia. So, when I went to check in, there was hardly any number of passengers. So, check-in was done in 2-3 minutes. And then I came out, had a tea or coffee with my friend who came to leave me. Swamiji, how come you came quickly? Say, there was no rush. Why there is no rush? I said, I asked the same question. Why there is no rush? They say, no, because of this 9-11, many people are afraid. Therefore, they have cancelled. Something may happen. I said, oh. But are you not afraid? I said, why should I be afraid? When you die alone, after death you will have a problem where to go. To whom you will ask? When the whole plane crashes, together we go. Chalo, company will be. Our death is the only action which we do and others suffer. Imagine I die right now here. You will have a problem of kya kare iska. I'll relax. Try karo. See, friends. Therefore, sarva grahopa samshantau swaimeva avashishyate. When everything is dropped, we come to a point what cannot be dropped. Friends, this experience you want to try to understand, just observe how you go to sleep. What is the process of going to sleep? We drop all achievements and failures, all friends and enemies, all relations and possessions, come to our house. We drop the whole house, go in our room. We drop all the contents of the room, go below the quilt. Switch off all the lights, and ultimately, last mantra continues. I want to sleep, I want to sleep, I want to sleep. Till such time, I and want is, sleep doesn't begin. And when even that I who wanted to sleep, when even that I is dropped, sleep begins, even in the satsang. That is the reason I like people who sleep in the satsang. Because they have already discarded the I. And those who are trying to understand, hold on, you will never understand. Therefore, learn the art of sleeping in satsang. And those who try to understand, why they want to tell others. Do you know Brahman? No, careless. This is a subjective experience, doesn't demand anybody's authentication. Therefore, swayameva avashishyate. This is the meaning of that purnamadaha purnamidam, purnar purnamudachyate, purnasya purnamadaya purnameva avashishyate. When all that can be dropped is dropped, what remains is you. Now, na tatra mana pekshasti swayam svaprakasha swarupataham tadrum vipatti apekshache shrutim pata gurur mukhat. Now, to know that I have recognized myself, then na mana apeksha. Mana means the pramana, the means of knowledge. How see? To see the colors and form, pramana, means of knowledge is vision. To experience the joy and sorrows, means of knowledge is mind. To understand the concepts, means of knowledge is intellect. Now, what is the means of knowledge? To know that I am. Do I know through my sense organs? Do I know through my mind? I feel I am there. Or do I know myself as a concept? In one of the universities in US, after my talk was over, the professor said to me, Mr. Swami, you presented the concepts very well. I said, excuse me, I did not talk concepts. You are a professor is a concept. You are successful is a concept. You are good is a concept. But you are is not a concept. Concepts are subject to change. And therefore, the truth is known only once. See, friends. Therefore, if you are expecting still that when I sit, I should get some experience. Other people, they see the light coming. Or the siddhis start manifesting. When you lit the fire, first the smoke starts coming out. and the smoke covers the fire. Exactly when the mind becomes slowly, unagitated, that pure mind brings out the smoke of siddhis. You can create anything by your will. In Patanjali Yoga Darshan, very clearly it is brought out. One can have the ability to mix up the five elements and create anything. Or you can disintegrate anything and make them into five elements. These start appearing when we become closer to our divine nature. That siddhi is called as the smoke on the fire of wisdom. But then we get lost. We get attracted towards that which is a source of some kind of siddhis. Therefore, if you are still expecting something to happen, then tadrup vipatti apeksha che, if you want, no, I want to know through something, then shrutim patha gurur mukhar, then go to the Guru Maharaj and study the scriptures. Friends, scriptures, we mean Upanishad. Scripture should not be studied independently, because the language of the scriptures is different than Sanskrit or English or Hindi. Like mouse, spelling is the same. Use both in English and computer science. So, a person who doesn't know anything about computer, he is told, okay, get the mouse, I'll show you. They will go, get a cage, catch a mouse and take this. Mouse is the same, but the language and the meaning is different. Cursor. You know, laptop. You have to take the cursor there. Curse everybody. In the same manner, when the scriptural language is not understood properly, we get lost. These friends. And the funniest part is that na tatra chakshur gacchati, na vaak gacchati, na manaha, na vidmaha, na tha, na yatha, etat anushishyat. The truth cannot be known through any means of knowledge. Not only that, we cannot know how to teach. Then why we have come to you? It is your mistake. No, not like that. Please tell what your guru told you. Okay, listen. My guru told me, Anya devatan viditat atha aviditat adiv. The truth is other than the known and the unknown. What if the truth is not told? Now you work. What is known? I know Tamil. Paramatma is not Tamil. Okay. I don't know Bengali. Paramatma is not Bengali. Now find out. All that is known to us is rejected. All that is not known to us is also rejected. No work. What is known? The effects are known. What is unknown? The cause is unknown. So, other than the known and unknown means what? That which is beyond the cause and effect. In being, there is no cause and effect. In becoming, cause, be plus cause is because. The more we get involved, why? Because the sky is too high. See friends, the day we understand this principle, when we do not ask the question why, we have transcended the limitation. For example, sometimes we are touched the fire in our childhood and we got to experience it burns. Thereafter we have never asked the question why the fire burns. Then we know the fire burns, so behave properly. That's it. The world is like this. Okay, then live in this world in such a manner that you remain protected. See friends, in Bengaluru, the traffic is the worst in the whole universe. So you know it is like that. Then suppose you have to reach there on 31st of January for a marriage, start on 1st of January, then you will reach there. This is how it is. Therefore, when we thus are able to read the scriptures through the instruction of the Guru, Guru Mukha Shrutim Pada, Yadi Sarva Graho Pashantya Ashakyastavi Dhyam Raja Sharadam Tad Adino Antar Bahir Yesho Anubhuyatam. And Yadi Sarva Graha Tyaga Ashakya. But you are not able to give up. You are earlier known. See, how can I just say I am not the body? Friends, whenever we have difficulties in practicing anything, the simple reason is we have zero value for that thing. We all have value for money. Has anybody ever said, earning money is difficult, therefore I am not going to earn the money? There we have a new techniques. Above the table, below the table, around the table, behind the table. Because we have value for the money. Exactly the same way, when we will have value for the spiritual experience, all your difficulties will disappear. Spiritual life is not the luxury of the useless people. See, friends, we have to be convinced of this. And it's for this purpose, regular study, contemplation, and one more thing, life stories of great masters must be read. When we read life stories, for example, take Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. If you keep on reading every day some small little account, every day you will get the right message for your spiritual evolution. In this manner, slowly, slowly, our orientation of the life becomes to the self. So we become self-oriented. Presently, we are self-centered. In this manner, Sarva Graha Tyaga Ashakya Tarim Dhyam Raja Sharanam. Take your intellect, surrender it at the feet of the teacher and go beyond the influence of the logic. You will know the truth. This is how this Natakdeep, like the lamb, illuminating everything in a theater but not getting influenced by anything, so is our experience. Childhood has come and gone, we are the same. Teenage has come and gone, we are the same. Joy has come and gone, we are the same. Waking and dream has gone, we are the same. We are this immutable being. You don't have to do anything. Whether you want or you don't want, you are divine. Whether you know or you don't know, you are divine. Only our scriptures have the courage to say this. You are not sent to the hell. If you do this thing, you will go to hell. It is okay for kids. Friends, in this manner we remain self-oriented. Thereafter, like Bhagavan Shankara says, Yogarato va bhogarato va sangarato va sangavihina yasya brahmani ramate chittam nandati 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 eva. Such a person is ever cheerful and happy. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om. Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.